All right, I'll share my screen. You can see my screen, right? Uttam, Abhilash? Okay, very good. So you must be having this Turbo C++ icon. Okay. Okay, very good. So, see, before we start, let me tell you one thing. So in any language, okay, whether it is C, C++, Java, you know, .NET, or Perl as he is using, Abhilash, right? So all these languages, right? So logic is always same, okay? That first you have to build a logic, right? That, okay, logic means the algorithm, right? Which you are, like, let's say if you want to solve a problem, right, then the logic will always be same, right? You can develop that logic, you can develop that logic, you know, in any language. Suppose, let me open one Excel sheet. Okay, so let's say we have given a problem that you have to print a series like this, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, right? So let's say if you want to print this one through your program, right? So what is happening here is that, let's say we are taking this number, this is the starting point and this is the end point, right? So if I take this starting number, so how I'm getting the next number? I'm adding just 2, right? So this is the algorithm that, you know, you add 2 in the previous number and you'll get the next number, right? So this is the logic, this is the algorithm. You can implement this algorithm in any language, okay? You can implement this in any language, right? So now what is the difference, like, you know, when we are implementing in different language, right? So every language gives its own benefits, right? That they have developed, you know, like how easy it is. Some languages are good in system programming, some languages are good in application programming, right? So, but again, 50% or you can say 75% is same. The logic is always same, only the syntax will be changed, okay? So when we talk about, like, you know, that language, right? So a language consists of syntax, right? What is the syntax we are going to use in that language, right? And your, conditions, right? And then you have loops and you have functions, okay? Syntax is like, you know, that how we should write, you know, every language has its own syntax, right? The syntax which are used in C or C++, right? Those syntax you cannot use in Perl or in any, or Java or in any other language, okay? There may be some similar syntax, but again, you know, both are different languages. But conditions, right? Conditions is again, let's say, you know, if you are going straight, right, then I say, okay, I'm writing a program, right? That okay, you have to reach to a destination, right? If you are writing a program for a car or for a game, right? And what you will do, like, you know, you will say, hey, if there is an obstacle, right? That okay, then what the decisions you have to take? Either you have to take left or right, right? Or you have to stop. So if you're, you know, in your game, a car is going straight, right? Then you can take decisions. Conditions means decision making, right? So you will say, hey, if, you know, that you get something in your way, then you have to turn left or right, or you have to stop, right? So if, then what? If it happens, then what? So these are called, like, you know, conditions you will get in any language. Okay, without this, you know, language is incomplete kind of. Loops, right? Loops is again, let's say you want to get a particular things done, like, you know, in iterative method. So there you can use, you know, these loops. So like, you know, that run this program, let's say what we are doing here, 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9, right? So what we are doing, we are, like, you know, taking this as a starting point, and then we are, you know, getting the next number. Until then, we have to write that program up to this, till we get this 9 number, right? Or you can say, so what you will do is you will run this program 4 times, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 times, the same program to reach up to, you know, these numbers, right? So you have run the same programs 5 times, get this variable, add 2, and get the next variable, right? So these things are, like, you know, you can write in loops. Similarly, what you can do is, like, you know, functions. Okay, so let's say there is a piece of code which you want to execute again and again, right? Why you want to use, I mean, let's say, okay, we'll discuss it later when, you know, we will go through, you know, this programming part. Okay, so let's move to this now. Start Turbo C++. Okay, all right. So this program was, like, you know, very simple program, right? So this is the way, like, you know, how we write a program in C or C++. This is a C++ term. Sorry. Yes. Uh-huh. Okay. Okay, I'll check after this class, yeah, with you, no problem. Yeah. So Abhilash, you are able to see this shortcut, or you are able to open this editor? Okay, very good. So Uttam, no problem, we'll see after this class, okay? Yes, Abhilash. Yeah, this is C++. See, now, okay, C, this is an extended version of C, okay? So whatever the syntax will work C, those all syntax works in C++. I'll tell you what is the difference, but that is fine. Now we use C++ only, okay? Yeah. So, see, any program or any work when you start, right? So you need a main function in C++ program. Main means, like, you know, that you are going to run. What is a program basically, right? A program is a set of instructions, right? That you are telling your computer to run these commands, correct? So you will start that program from somewhere, right? That somewhere means there should be always a starting point. In any language, that your program will start running from this point, that, you know, every language has a main function, okay, or you can say a main point, right? So in C++, we start our program from main. Okay, these are like, you know, include stdio.h, conio.h, okay, standard input output. So these things I'll explain you later, but for now what we will do is we'll just start writing small programs. So this is again, okay, so there are some functions which are given by C++ language, okay. So this CLR, SCR is for, like, you know, to clear your screen is used. So this is given by again C++. Printf is also to print whatever is this, you know, written inside it is given by C++, and this is also a C++ function, okay. In any language, there is a facility like, you know, that also these are, there are three statement, okay. So in this, we have, you know, this main function, under this main functions we have three statement. Each statement is separated by this colon, semicolon, okay. All right, and if you want to see, like, you know, okay, so once you write your statement, then okay, it is given, you know, over here that if you want to save, you can press shortcut as a F2, right? And then if you want to compile, you can compile in this way. Okay, so after writing your program, what we need to do is we have to compile our program. Okay, we have to compile our program. What it means is actually whatever you are doing over here, it is getting written in this file, myfirst.cpp. Okay, so to save that permanently, you have to, you know, you can press this F2 key, or you can go here and you can then save in file. Okay, and then, okay, so whatever you have written over here, that is correct or not, for that you have to compile your program. So what compiled means, like, you know, it compiles, okay, it compiles that this program is written, you know, according to C++ language or not. So it checks the syntax, right, whatever you have written. So let's say if I remove, okay, if I, you know, click on this Alt F9, or you can go here and click here compile, right, then it says warnings and errors. Okay, if errors are zero, right, it means that your program is okay. Okay, then, and let's say if I remove something from here and then compile, so it says that there is one error. Okay, there is one error. All right, and it tells, like, you know, what that error is. Functions GTCH should have a prototype. So, okay. Now let's say if I run this program. So, okay. F2. And then Alt F9, okay. F9 is to run this program.